and welcome. I'm Amanda Kibble, and along with my co-director Janelle Hesch and the tech director Dan Carlson, we welcome you to our play. It's called Caught in the Act. We have had so much fun the last 6 weeks rehearsing and practicing, and the kids have worked really, really hard to put on their best performance for you. However, the past couple of days, we've had a few little challenges. We've had some last-minute unexpected changes to the cast. So I just wanted to let everybody know kind of what of those changes are. I'm really proud of everyone, how they've stepped up. And with that being said, we have Maddie Kraft in tonight as Paige for Jacqueline Bocamp. We have Isabel Aldrink in for Travis Boyle's role of Sergeant Hawk. We have Olivia Watercott in playing Julius Stokes' role of Sylvia. And then Ellie Hullawa was not able to perform either, and her role of the mover is filled within the cast. So I also have some of my seniors here, and they would like to introduce themselves and let you know what role they're playing tonight in the show.
Hello, my name is Mason Reiches, and I may or may not be Arthur, and I hope you enjoy the show.
I am Ali Rhoda, and I am playing the role of Jan, and this is your reminder to turn off your phone.
I am Jelena Bielke. I play the role of Callie, and we would just like to say thank you for coming to the show tonight.
My name is Jacob Owenthal, and I will be playing the role of Ace. And since this is a funny show, if you want to laugh, please feel free to. And though I hope you don't want to, if you feel the need to cry, we will allow you to just this once.
I'm Nicholas Yoakum. I'm playing the part of Mr. Habershaw, and the guy in front of me said everything I was going to say, so.
Hold it.
What?
What are you doing?
Setting up chairs for the auditions.
So am I.
Well, geez, I thought I was going crazy.
The chairs go stage left.
Stage left?
You got it.
what?
I said stage left.
Right.
No, left.
That's what I said.
You said right.
You said left.
Stage left.
This is left.
Right.
That's what I said.
No, you're putting them right.
Then what are you complaining about?
Stage right. You're putting them stage right.
Hold it. This is the stage, right?
No, this is stage right.
I need a map. Where am I?
Center stage.
I know, the center where we do all the shows.
But you're at center stage.
And the chairs go on the left.
No, they go on stage left.
But I'm putting the chairs on the left of the stage.
Yes, but the left of the stage is not stage left.
Then you do it.
Fine.
This is right?
Left!
I mean, is this correct?
Now you got it.
But it's to the right.
You face out, idiot. See, everything in theater, all the directions, are from the standpoint of face the audience. So when they say stage left...
Oh, they go over there.
Attaboy! Now can we get the rest of the chairs?
Sure. Over here. Stage left.
What a crouton.
Callie, will you help me with these chairs?
What?
Help me with these chairs.
Gotcha. Myron, you did it again! I said we put the rest of the chairs right here next to the others.
What others?
Didn't we put chairs here?
You mean stage here?
Don't be so stupid. Where are the chairs we set up?
This place must be haunted!
You're the one that's haunted.
Okay, then where are the chairs?
You're doing this on purpose, just to make me look like a fool in front of all these people.
No. One of the perks.
We'll be with you in a minute. We'll get audition started just as soon as our director arrives, and what?
She has arrived.
Oh, Gracie, we were just setting up the chairs.
What chairs?
Okay, you have to take my word for this. There is a flock of chairs right over there.
Don't worry about it. Let's get this thing underway.
Now, as all of you know, or some of you know, or maybe only two or three of you know, or none of you know.
You don't have a social life, do you?
Huh?
Okay, our next production is Hark, Hark, the Dumplings. I'm Gracie Clench, the person who vowed never to direct another show again, but got blackmailed into directing another show again. Now, if you will all try to behave, nobody will be hurt, okay? Who wants to go first?
Hey, I don't know whether we were supposed to bring a script or
where did you park?
Good. Maybe I won't have to bring duct tape to rehearsals this time.
Where's the chairs?
Shut up.
Maybe they're next to the donuts.
Wait, there are...
All of you, settle down. Let's get this thing started.
Okay, let's just get to the readings. I have several scenes ready. Where are they?
Oh, the scenes. They're out in my car. And I thought, hey, I'll go get them.
Like talking to a black hole.
I don't like the play we're doing.
Okay, raise of hands. Anybody care? You will bear with us, won't you, Princess?
Just thought I'd mention it.
If I'm gonna be late, you're gonna have to write me a note.
Hey, if you don't get in the play, then you won't be late.
If I write it, will you sign it?
Okay, no new faces, so I have a pretty good idea of what you all are capable of. And I also know what you'll resort to.
She retorted, staring at me only.
Hey, Madge, what are you doing? Just getting a jump on the costumes, dear. Do you mind? 28. Do you play football?
I wear a size 10.
Yeah, and a shoe.
Do you get any free tickets this time?
Only those we can't sell.
Lots of free tickets.
Okay. Does anybody know if anybody else is coming?
Operators are standing by.
Is Viola here?
Is she coming?
Is she here?
No.
She may be coming.
How do you know?
She's not here.
Oh, Madge, I never knew you had these feelings.
Cool it.
Okay, as you all can see, I started auditions on a bare stage. I don't want anybody sitting down. We're all going to be on our feet and... Where did all these chairs come from?
I didn't have anything to do with that.
Oh, hear the kissy noises? Hark!
Gustavus Adolphus Lutheran Church.
What?
That's where the chairs came from.
We stole chairs from a church?
They gave them to us?
We're that poor?
Only in money, talent, and spirit.
Get those chairs off the stage.
I just sat down.
Where do you want them? Stage right or stage left?
Move them over by the air conditioner, migrant.
People don't know what to put up with.
Okay. Does anybody have any conflicts?
Not if you sign my note.
Enough! Anybody else?
I have an audience with the Pope on the 5th. He'll understand.
Can we get started? My cat hasn't seen me in 2 hours. It's supposed to be a tropical trip.
We're getting started. Where are the scenes?
Just a second. Does anyone know how to get into a locked car?
That does it. I'm moving to New Zealand.
Myron, can you turn down the air conditioner? It's cold in here. I can see my breath.
Face facts. Chuck, it doesn't have to be cold to see your breath.
I hope we have a love scene.
Okay, can somebody get Lucy into her car?
Ooh, and bring me a burger.
And some french fries.
Myron!
Oh, what?
Can you get Lucy into her car?
And she calls me stupid?
Don't be so obtuse.
That way, we can get started when she gets back.
Obtuse?
Me. Okay, this show calls for a cast of 15. 11 women and 4 men.
Ooh, can I play the man this time?
Pardon me. What? Is this where the auditions are held? I'm new here.
New?
She is new.
And different.
Burn her at the stake.
And you are? Darla. Last name? Gundelfinger. No, really. Really? Gundelfinger?
It sounds like a candy bar.
To you, everything sounds like a candy bar.
This is the place, Darla. She works with me down at the soap factory.
I'm in lather.
Me too.
I've always heard of your little show here, and it's always sounded like fun.
Can you forge signatures?
She could always try the Carousel Community Theater.
Oh. Oh. Carousel Community Theater? Who are they?
Our rivals.
Our worst enemies.
And they do better shows than we do.
They do not.
Right.
Have you done anything before on stage?
In front of an audience? What is it with you, Helen? Somebody drop a house on your sister?
Do you mind? Well, I've done a few things.
A few things? She was in a tour show once and an understudy.
So, naturally, she works at a soap factory.
It's one of the better smelling factories. I'd be happy to fill out any questionnaires, give you resume, fingerprint, blood sample? Not necessary.
What was that about the fingerprints?
Well, I have a question.
What?
Do they still use horses to make soap?
No!
You'll have to forgive him, dear. When he was born, his parents were expecting a human.
Dina, hush up. And get up! Where did you get that chair?
The Pope. Well, since Ace canceled his audience.
Okay. Does anybody have anything prepared?
I thought you said we didn't have to have anything.
Then you don't, do you?
That's right.
Then what are you complaining about?
I think I lost my place.
Darla, why do you want to be in our show here?
Do you date co-actors?
Smooth Ace.
I don't think so.
Well, then just tell the little old director here whatever your little old heart desires.
Bachelor number one comes from the state of desperation. His hobbies include drinking heavily and writing his phone number down on bathroom stalls. He'll take a fax number if you don't want to give him your phone number.
Give Darla room, folks!
Come on, nothing to see here. Hit him up, move him out. Move along.
You want to be on stage because...
Well, it's the only show in town, and when you think about it, it's not something you have to think about. You simply want to act. Get up on some dark stage, pretend to be someone you're not in front of a crowd of strangers, and say a bunch of lines you probably don't understand, but as odd as that may seem, that makes you happy. Like I said, it's the only show in town.
Huh? Oh, me? I like being part of the group. In high school, I wasn't really part of a group, part of anything. But here, I know everybody, and everybody knows me. Even when we get new people, I know they're a lot like me. You know what they call a common bond thingy? We're all a part of it. The group, made up mostly of people that couldn't get into any other group. Wait, can I start over? I guess not.
I'm here mainly because one time I came to pick Ace up from rehearsal, and the next thing I knew, I was in the opening scene. I was really looking for that class on welding. I don't know if I'm a good actor, but I still can't weld worth a flip.
It keeps me from eating.
Well, one time I read an article in People magazine about somebody. I don't remember who it was and how she lacked self-confidence. So she joined this group, I don't remember when, but now she's gone on to win all sorts of awards and stuff. I don't remember which one. But now she's happily married to, what's his face? Oh, and it helps me with my memory.
I saw an ad. You know, the one talking about auditions for a show here. Thought I'd give it a whirl. If I had some of those artistic instincts it mentioned, that it takes to delve into my inner soul and find a bit of untapped talent. But really, I just was here to meet new friends. Boy friends, in particular. It was either this welding class, I...
The guy in front of me said everything I was gonna say.
It's fun, isn't it? It's like playing, pretending, sort of. I've always been afraid of growing up, you know, just growing up with our parents just for day after day and nothing in between. I mean, that's what I remember most about adults when I was a kid. This is like recess. I don't know if it's a little like therapy.
I just want to be in the spotlight.
It gets me out of the house. Charlie won't take me anywhere, no matter how many times I ask. Let's go somewhere, anywhere, I don't care where. Dinner, dancing, ball game, do you think he listens? No, he got his buddies at the garage and that's all. I told him if he won't take me anywhere, I'll get in a show and then he'll have to come see one. I've been in this group for 8 years and so far he hasn't stepped foot in the building.
Well, they pay me to be here.
I think I'm here because right now I can't get in my car to leave. Does anybody belong to a car club?
Rehearsals start Monday, everybody. And Mr. William Shakespeare, please forgive us. We're just beginners.
This goes over here.
No, it goes over here.
She said stage left.
What?
Stage left.
I thought it goes over here.
Let's just put it down here.
You know, you didn't have to snap at me.
Get in the middle of something carrying a ton of furniture and that's when you get technical?
I just asked.
I'm afraid I've just been given terrible news this morning. It's Sir Harry. He's dead.
No.
It happened during his afternoon fox hunt. Horse fell under him. It all happened so quickly. Of course they had to shoot him.
Sir Harry?
The horse. Now he's the pride of the whole countryside.
The horse?
Sir Harry. Oh, what a game hunter he was too.
Sir Harry?
The horse. He sounded quite a bird, you know.
The horse.
Sir Harry. Oh, we all love putting them together tonight.
Going to be a coin toss on this one.
It doesn't say that!
It's a little confusing.
It's supposed to be. That's where the conflict comes from later.
You want conflict? Try getting us out of this love seat.
Hey!
Hang on.
Oh, thank you.
Make a note. Get a bigger sofa.
But it's supposed to be this confusing early in the show?
We're trying to fool the audience. And, at the same time, start the plot. You have to make a big to-do about the plot. And here is where the plot starts. And it has to sound confusing.
Gracie, I just got a phone call from someone.
Who?
They said to tell JD that the backer will be in the audience opening night.
What?
Backer?
Wait a minute. There's no one here named JD.
That's what I said, but they told me to post the note anyway.
Backer? But we're already opening here and...
Wait just a ding-dong minute there, Scarlett. A backer wants to see this show?
It's probably just a prank.
That means they want to put money in the show.
And then do what?
Nothing! Forget it! It's just a note.
We better get better and fast.
A producer is coming to see the show.
Now don't start this. All we need right now is a bunch of false rumors.
Hey, it might be a real rumor.
Just drop it, okay?
What's the scene here, folks?
A producer is coming to see the show.
A producer?
You mean somebody wants to take Hark Hark the Dumplings on tour?
Nobody said anything about a tour.
Then why is a producer interested in the show?
It's just a note.
To JD.
Who's JD?
Nobody.
Nobody? Nobody gets a note here?
Hey, nobody gets more mail than I do.
Or she does.
That's right. It could be a she.
If she has a backer coming to take the show to New York.
Or maybe even further.
Hold it.
What do you mean?
How about taking the show to the Great White Way?
This from the Great White Shark.
Okay, what does JD stand for?
Juvenile Delinquent.
Junior Development?
Jack Daniels. Hey, I went to college.
Did you hear?
What?
Nothing.
We're going to Broadway!
What? Will you stop? All we have is one note from somebody nobody knows to somebody else nobody ever heard of. And look at you, flying off in all directions. You people are the worst gossips in the world.
She started it.
I did not.
All of you!
I should have just given you the note first, shouldn't I?
That's right.
I'm sorry.
That's okay.
Oh, by the way, you told me when it's time to remind you to go take your pill.
Oh, right. Go over your lines, everybody. Be right back.
Pill?
She's taking pills?
I wonder what for. You know, she has been looking a little pale lately.
Oh, all vampires look like that.
It's probably for her blood pressure.
You think?
Yeah. Notice how every time she gives me a direction, that vein in her neck just pops out.
Looks like the Mississippi River. Ooh, I bet that means heart problems.
She's got heart problems?
That must be it. She's always saying that this is her last show. What if she means this is her last show?
What? Everybody give up smoking today?
Are you all right?
What do you think himself?
Want to lie down?
That's your answer for everything.
What is it now? Oh, right. The pills.
It's okay. We understand.
Do you need someone to drive you home?
I like the chewables.
There's a bulletin.
I had to take pills before.
What a revelation!
It's nothing. I just... Go back to the rumor about the backer.
Oh, we're going to Broadway!
Woo!
See? I always said we'd make it with talent like... Well, me for one.
Oh, you're so modest.
Sincerity, that's the key. If you can fake that, you can fake anything.
Can we get back to rehearsal?
What's all the rhubarb?
Rhubarb?
My dad worked in a circus.
We got a producer coming to take the show to New York. We got a note.
It didn't say anything about New York, and we didn't get a note. It was for someone named J.D.
J.D.? Oh, that's Darla.
Yeah.
You're JD?
Now it's a Greek chorus.
Jeanette Darla, that's my name.
Yeah, we call her JD down at the factory.
Well, you got a note about some backer coming to opening night.
Yeah, tell us all about it. Backer? Oh, he probably said Packer. Max, one of the guys from Packing, probably called. He's a Packer.
Oh.
See? What did I tell you?
We were so close.
Yeah, just a few phone calls away.
Can we get back to rehearsal? Please?
What for? We're not going anywhere.
Oh, everybody take a 5-minute break.
Thank you, five.
Honestly, unbelievable.
We don't have a packing section at the factory, so how could you know a packer?
I don't.
So if that call wasn't from a packer, then it was from a...
Hey, Arthur, do you have the sound working yet? Arthur, do you have the sound working? Okay, what about the seagulls? Fine. Stick around and we'll run a few others when we need them. Arthur, can you hear me? Cute.
Isn't funny. Can we do something about him?
Like what?
have him killed?
Arthur! Do you have a question, or are you just airing out your mouth?
Thing is, I've been reading the script.
Now, I told you not to do that.
Well, I have just one question.
Just a second. Can we finish setting up the stage and step on it?
What kind of show is this?
It's a farce. Okay, everybody on stage for vocal warm-ups.
Vocal warm-ups? This isn't a musical.
You always warm up your vocal cords, whether it's a musical or not. This is to help our pronunciation. We want to hear the words crisp and clear.
Whatever you say, my dear.
Okay. Miu, miu, miu.
Miu, miu, miu.
Hubba-bubba, hubba-bubba, hubba-bubba.
I had an old Chrysler that used to idle like that.
You, up a ladder, up a ladder.
Up a ladder, up a ladder.
Why don't we just do row your boat?
26 stitches, 26 stitches.
Oh sure, you'd give me that one.
Do it.
26 stitches.
Duck. Duck call, duck call.
I hope I don't make a mistake.
Duck call, duck call.
Duck call, duck call, duck call.
Never mind the furthermore, the plea is self-defense. It's a line from Oklahoma.
Never mind the
more, the plea is self-defense.
Never mind the furthermore, the plea is self-defense.
Up a ladder, 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 up a ladder.
Is this Gilbert and Sullivan?
I can't understand you.
You know I can't understand Gilbert and Sullivan. Is there someone here to see you?
Bring him in here.
What?
Bring him in here.
Wait for now.
Up a ladder, up a ladder, up a ladder.
Okay, now I want you to do it backwards.
Up a ladder, 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 up a ladder.
Here he is, says it's official business.
What?
Says he's on an investigation.
Sergeant Hawk,
you're a cop?
Yes, ma'am, and I need to ask you a few questions. I'm looking for a known criminal working in this county.
Okay, everybody, take five.
What's going on?
Just a routine investigation.
We'll do whatever we can to help.
Yeah, we're already in the lineup.
Are you the one in charge around here?
That would be Gracie. Hey, she is not here right now, and I am second in command. That's why she chose me, remember?
I thought you gave her money.
You're...
Lucio Bumfistick. I can tell you anything and everything you need to know. People ask me all sorts of questions around here.
Yeah, like, how are you?
Can you move your car?
He understands.
Are you going to be in there all day?
He gets the idea.
Look, we got a tip that this notorious criminal was wanted by the FBI. Said she might be pursuing her old habits. Used to be an actress. Can't seem to keep away from the stage. That kind of thing.
And you think she's here?
Oh, we're checking all theaters in the area. Her name is Phoebe Twitchwell.
There's no one around here by that name.
Don't be too sure, Missy. She might be using an alias.
Well, what does she look like?
Well, that's the problem.
That bad, huh? Ugh.
We just don't have a good picture of her. She's a master of disguises. A clever devil she is. She can make herself look very young or very old. Tall and even short. She can even pose as a man wearing a beard. Sometimes she walks with a limp. In short, she could be anybody, anywhere.
So then how will you know when you find her?
Well, that's her one fault. Something that will lead us right to her. Whenever she gets up on stage, she forgets her lines.
Well, shoot, you might as well arrest us all.
That's it? That's all you have?
One more thing. One vital clue.
And that is?
I'll tell you. She's allergic to roses. Has anybody been sneezing lately?
But what's she wanted for?
Murder. She's a pretty desperate number, all right. So keep your eyes out, your ears open. She might be under our very noses.
You don't need a detective. You need an ear, nose, and throat man.
Hey, everybody, look at what you sent me.
Roses!
She's packing!
Oh. Oh, no, we're not doing calisthenics again, are we?
Roses. And they, don't bother you?
No.
May I?
Sure.
Remember when you got them? Who is this guy, and what does he want with my flowers?
He's an investigator.
I didn't steal those.
Just a second.
Well, no reaction so far.
What's he looking for?
To see if anyone's allergic to roses.
Well, it wouldn't work with those.
Why not?
They're plastic.
Here.
What's going on? We're just doing a play, right? A farce, not a mystery?
It started out as a farce. But now, it is a mystery. What the heck was that?
Arthur!
Ready? And go!
As you can see, our scene quickly shifts into something completely different. What exactly is happening? What is going on?
Up we are to the pastoral serenity of the open countryside where my lady hopes to fulfill her ardent desires of Sir Reginald.
Who, unbeknownst to her, has presently fled in order to have a tryst with the chambermaid?
Who, as we have seen before, is really Penelope in disguise?
Who is the Duke's daughter?
Who is also currently residing in the countryside with his sister?
Who is in fact not his sister due to a mix-up at birth with Lady Mumford?
Who is really who?
Who knows for sure? Who cares?
What, how, and where without? I have come within having wandered hither and yon, and now having the wherewithal seek the whereabouts of my ne'er-do-well nephew, who wears on my whatever. So hereafter I shall seek whereafter, for who after is after my whatever. This place stinks.
Stop! Everybody back out here.
Well, it does. And I want you to put a sign out in the lobby. Please don't shoot the actors. It's not their fault.
Who asked you? And where's your voice?
I swallowed it.
I mean your accent. You're going to practice on your accent.
I'm not ready yet. Give me a break. And you were going to have a coach come in and work with us. Remember?
Hey, be nice to her. She's not feeling well.
fine! What's with all this ruckus over how I'm feeling lately? That's all everyone seems to ask me. Jan brought me some chicken soup last night, and tonight I found an industrial-sized bottle of aspirin on my clipboard. And who left that hospital brochure?
Pixies?
Yeah, they're everywhere.
And generally dressed like us.
Will you stop? I'm fine, okay?
It's your blood pressure.
It's not my blood pressure!
Do you want to lie down for a minute?
If someone asks me that one more time...
Do I have this on right?
I think I need to lay down.
Depends. What are you?
I'm not real sure.
You look like a sideshow.
Yeah, half woman, half patio furniture.
Hey! She just hasn't gotten it fixed yet.
I should hope not.
Yeah.
There? It looks like she's going to some kind of Hawaiian rodeo. What do you want?
This is the strangest show you've ever done.
Wait till you see Act Two.
What is it, Myron?
Oh, Mr. Habershaw is backstage.
The owner of the building?
He wants to know if it's safe to come out here.
He's afraid of us?
Yeah, remember when he showed up on stage last time and you guys were doing West Side Story?
Oh yeah, it was during the knife fight.
Hey, I thought he did all right for a man his age.
For him not having a knife.
No, I think he was mostly scared of the dancers.
Mr. Habershaw!
Hello?
It's okay, sir. It's safe.
You sure? I've got more insurance now.
It's okay, sir. Really? We're all quite harmless.
Why are you carrying a spear?
Just a prop.
Hey, I am responsible for that.
Now, what can I do for you?
Well, I hate to intrude. I can see you're all busy, but something has come up that I think should be brought to your attention.
I'm all ears. Everybody, relax.
Dress like this?
Good, I need a break.
Now, what is it, sir?
Well, the thing is, I'm selling the theater.
What?
Selling the theater? Did you hear that?
What?
He's selling the theater!
Selling the theater?
Who is?
He is.
Who's he?
He owns the place.
And he's doing what?
Selling the theater!
Selling the theater?
That one got around fast. Mr. Habershaw, you're selling the theater?
It didn't sound as bad when I said it.
Oh, but when? And to who?
I have a buyer who's going to start a cable show. In fact, he's going to start a home shopping program. Of course, the theater would be perfect for that type of operation with cameras and microphones and...
Oh, but when?
Well, immediately. That's why I took the chance on. Took the chance on coming out here on station. I couldn't even miss out, sir.
Yeah, what's shaking?
What's going on?
He's selling the theater.
Selling the theater?
Will you stop?
So, you're gonna have to cancel the show.
Cancel the show?
He wants us to cancel the show?
Why does everybody repeat and I say...
We can't cancel the show! The show must go on!
Thank you, P.T. Barnum. Mr. Habershaw, isn't there something I can say? Something I can do to make you change your mind?
I hope this isn't bad news for you, Miss Howitzer.
I mean, we need to make plans. We need to make arrangements. Isn't there something we can do? Can't we talk this over?
Well, I guess we could talk about it.
You and who?
Well, maybe you who.
You who?
The plot thickens.
Well, that would be very nice. Maybe with a late dinner with our representative.
That sounds swell.
Why, Captain Habershaw, how you talk.
That's your accent?
I should come back after rehearsal's over, if that's okay with you, Miss Howitzer.
Swell.
Fine, fine. I'm sure you two can work it out.
Until then, Miss Howitzer?
I shall count the minutes.
One Mississippi, two Mississippi. Mississippi.
What are you wearing?
Bye-bye.
Toodles! The things I do for the theater.
He's always had the galloping hots for you, you know.
Really?
You might need this.
Now, what's all this about stopping the show?
Nothing.
You know something. She knows something. You know something.
No, I don't. Only...
Only what?
Nothing!
Callie,
what is it? Well, remember back on the first night of rehearsals when someone left a note for JD saying that a backer was coming in opening night, but then Darla said it wasn't a backer but a packer? Well, it turns out what we all thought it was in the first place.
Do you scuba dive?
So you mean there really is a producer coming to see the show?
And take us to Broadway and...
Oh, don't start that one again! You people! I can't believe this! This place is nothing but a back fence to you, isn't it? First, we have the rumor that some big-time producer is coming to take us all to New York. Next, there's the one that says I'm on death's door.
Don't forget about the murderer.
And then some guy shows up. Well, I'm not, by the way.
Hey, that's right. You were homesick.
Do you want to lie down for a minute?
Someone who doesn't even show anyone his credentials tells you that he's a police officer looking for a wanted criminal, a murderer, no less. And the only thing he has about this criminal is that he or she is allergic to roses.
Hey, it could happen. What, you never worked on some mystery before?
That's it. I want you to drop all of the rumors and just concentrate on doing the show, okay? I don't want you thinking about any Broadway openings. I don't want you figuring out how to fingerprint anybody. And I don't want anybody, ever asking me how I feel ever again. Is that clear?
Yes, ma'am.
I can't hear you.
Yes, ma'am.
Golly, Sergeant Carter.
Now, go spend the next 10 minutes going over your lines while Dina and I try to figure out a way to stop Mr. Habershaw from selling this place. Is that clear?
Yeah.
I can't believe these people. You don't mind going on a date with Mr. Habershaw?
You're asking me now?
Just skip the story and come back to me. If anyone could talk him out of selling this place, you can. Besides, it'll give the group something else to talk about besides that story of having a murderer loose in the theater.
You know, one of these days, I'm gonna get a social life. But for now...
I hope you don't mind. I brought along a little peace offering. Here. For you.
For little old me? Why, Mr. Habershaw, you shouldn't have.
Well, I... Oh, shoot.
This is ever so nice. Why, they're lovely. Phew! Let's just go backstage and get them in some water.
Whatever you say, my dear.
Yeah, something else to talk about besides that story of having a murderer loose in the theater. With allergies. Arthur! Oh, for heaven's sakes, just kill the lights.
You do know a producer, and he's coming here to see the show?
How did you meet him?
And is he interested in just you or the whole show?
And does he have the money to show back to himself?
Or is he raising the money from other investors? And is he talking about Broadway or not? Would he date older women? I'm trying to get my mother out of the house. And why did you make up a story about him not being a producer? Yeah, don't you like us?
I wish you guys would just forget you ever heard about him.
So it is true. He really is a producer.
Hi, guys. Callie.
Uh-oh.
She'll be back. Listen, We need to make plans.
What kind of plans?
Our parts. We need to make sure we have them down cold.
And it wouldn't hurt for them to be bigger.
What do you mean? Odd lines?
Who's gonna know the difference? This thing stinks anyways.
Yeah, anybody can write this type of stuff.
Has anyone seen Gracie?
Not yet. You know, I always thought my part took a little bit more passion.
What? Passion? You're playing a horse.
Yeah, just the front end. I'm playing the...
Has anyone seen Mr. Habershaw?
Ooh, who cares about him?
Yeah, let him get his own agent.
Ooh, agents.
Are we all gonna need agents now?
Where do you find one?
I think they hang around pool halls.
How do you figure?
Well, they gotta make money somehow.
Not pool halls, you idiot. Pools, they hang around swimming pools.
But if Habershaw closes the theater...
He won't. Gina took care of that.
Can we stop talking about murders? This is important. Can I borrow someone's lipstick?
I couldn't help myself!
Yes? He decided to help me?
Hey, how do you recognize the guy, the producer? Let's give him a name tag.
But we should find him first.
Is everyone getting into the spirit of the show yet? We're working on Act 2 now, you know?
Yeah, sure. Darla knows him.
So she'd know what he looks like. Starting to pay attention now, are you?
I didn't really tell them anything!
Yeah? Just stop and tell me exactly what you didn't tell them!
There she is.
Uh-oh.
Make her tell!
I guess you have. You've really been working on their pacing, haven't you?
Yeah, they're really on their toes when they're around me.
What about those quick entrances and exits? How's that coming along? There you are!
Oh my!
Very nice, but what are they saying?
It's an improv.
Oh, very good. Has Dina shown up yet?
I haven't seen her. Of course, you don't know who's gonna come out of door number one, door number two, or door number three.
What in the heck?
Where did you come from?
I don't really know. I was just standing back there, and this posse rushed by and shoved me out here. Oh, and there was a phone call for you.
Who's it from?
Beats me. Someone looking for Mr. Habershaw.
You knew about the tracker. What does he look like?
I don't know. I'm just an innocent bystander.
There's a phone number there.
I better call and see what this is all about. Lucy, go take Chuck and show him his costume.
Right.
What are you waiting for?
Can't run forever!
Thanks. Now we can go.
I wonder who is looking for Mr. Habershaw. He's not married. And the last time we saw him, he was with Dina. And they were... Oh, this can't be happening. She did sneeze when he gave her those roses. Oh, this is getting off hand. I better see what's going on. And...
Callie, we're on your side.
Yeah, well, here's my back.
Will you two stop?
I wish we had a stun gun.
Oh no!
Whoa, girl.
Hey, I'm not a horse.
That's my part.
Just the back end.
Okay, part of my part. Look, Callie, we're going to find out sooner or later, and I think...
What?
Gracie, look!
Look, I can't tell you anything.
You mean you won't tell us anything?
Yeah, and we... Oh, Gracie. What happened?
She's fainted.
The disease.
Somebody got to her.
She's been murdered!
There really is a killer on the loose. Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, no.
Stop that. that for?
I needed that.
Ah!
She's alive! Help her up!
What do we do? What do we do?
Give her air! Not that much air! Get her up!
You said to give her air. Her to the couch. Be careful. My mother has these spells.
She does? What's she got?
Teenagers.
Put her down gently. Gently.
It can't be happening.
She's trying to talk.
Tell her not to talk.
Gracie, try not to talk.
Tell her to just relax and breathe easy.
What am I, the interpreter?
Dina.
What'd she say? Dina.
What about Dina?
The murderer. Dina.
Oh no, she knows something.
The murderer's after Dina.
No, she is the murderer.
Dina's the murderer?
What?
What's going on?
Gracie, you're all right.
Yeah, I must have.
You just told us about Dina.
I have? I mean, you know?
That she's the killer?
Game plan here.
There she is.
The murderer.
What, me?
Just do something.
Get her. Uh-oh.
Run before she gets to her car.
Now it's your turn. Huh? Wait! No! You don't understand! I didn't say I knew! I just thought that maybe Dina was!
Gracie, are you alright? She must be. Hey, has anyone seen Gracie?
And wherewithout I have come within having wandered hither and yon, and now having no idea of my next line. And now the wherewithal seek the whereabouts of my ne'er-do-well nephew, who wears galoshes and a butterfly net. I don't know what.
Hold it! Where's on my whatever?
Ever. Why do we have to do this part?
Look, you're the only one left. Nobody has heard from Dina, and she's not answering her calls.
Why don't we just turn her to the police, and when they find her, she can do the part.
Look, we open in 3 days, and you're going to do the part. It's as simple as that.
But what if somebody murders me?
Then you won't do the part.
I guess every cloud is a silver lining.
Will you stop with that stupid rumor? There is no killer in this group, and nobody is going to be murdered.
Tell him!
Huh? Sergeant Hawk, will that be all?
Sergeant Hawk, I don't believe we've met.
Yes, I am Sergeant Hawk.
What can I do for you?
We have news from federal authorities that the killer is in your group, and somebody may have been murdered.
What were you saying? Sergeant, if you know all this, then you must know who the killer is.
Afraid not. It could be anybody.
Don't look at me. The killer needs a motive, doesn't he?
Yeah? How do you feel about the actors?
Oh, I would just love to kill... Never mind.
I'd keep an eye on him if I were you.
Look, Sergeant, you don't know who the killer is.
Dina.
What they look like.
Dina.
Or where they live.
Dina's house.
What's that, man?
I said she doesn't know anything.
Well, we still need to catch her in the act.
Act one or act two?
Enough.
I just wanted to tell you that I will be here opening night. That's when she usually strikes.
Opening night?
To get the headlines. But it'll be all right. I will be backstage and some of my men will be out front.
Oh, do any of them want a part in the play?
Won't be necessary. I'll see you in 3 nights.
This is getting ridiculous. A killer that's going to commit a murderer on opening night. That's just melodramatic.
I'm starting to get scared. Or melodramatic. I can never tell those two apart.
Ugh. And yeah? What am I supposed to do with that?
What if we just don't do an opening night?
And how do we manage that?
We do the show on the second night.
But that would make the second night opening night.
Oh, right. This is getting tricky.
Gracie, how's your head?
It's still attached. But check with me on Friday. I just wanted to tell you that, well, you heard about that backer coming, and the thing is, I didn't mean for that to get out, and I'm sorry for all the trouble it's caused.
A bit late for that.
Anyway, he is coming to the show.
He is?
I better get these lines memorized.
Oh, there's an idea.
Then, since the note was true, he'll be coming here on opening night. That's right. But don't worry, no one knows who he is besides me.
Opening night.
That's right. I'll introduce him after the show. Oh, he'll be in disguise.
In disguise.
That's so Dina can't murder him.
Will you stop saying that?
Me? You're the one that said she's the killer.
All I said was that I thought she might be the killer because she sneezed at the roses, and that's all we have.
And then Mr. Habershaw disappeared?
Well, that is true. He could be taking a nap somewhere.
May I interject?
Huh?
What is it now?
Well, a phone call came in from some secretary or another. Said they want tickets for their boss.
So?
Well, it seems that he, her boss, is the person who wants to buy tickets for Mr. Habershaw. But since he can't get Mr. Habershaw on the phone right now, he, that is, her secretary, that is, the secretary's boss.
What did the buyer want?
Tell you, he said, that is, his secretary said that he...
Myron!
Buyer's coming to the show.
When?
Wait, let me guess. Opening night.
Well, if you knew I was gonna say, why'd you make it go on like that?
Did you keep track of all of that?
Well, as near as I get it, if we don't do the show, the killer will still be loose and the backer won't put any money into it. But if we do the show, the backer may see it and invest in it, the buyer may take over the theater and turn it into a cable channel, and somebody will wind up dead.
That's about it.
Except?
If we do the show, we might catch a killer.
If the police are fast enough.
And then we catch him red-handed.
Which means?
If somebody gets murdered.
Hold me!
Will, you stop!
Sorry.
Any ideas?
What if we just did act one?
Look, we gotta keep going. There's no killer running loose. I'm telling you.
You really?
Oh, here. Hold back and work on your lines. And this time, without the script.
Gracie?
Yeah?
You're starting to believe me now?
I think so, yeah. How about we go get a burger?
Good idea.
Let me show you.
I go to your left.
That's stage left. Try it again.
Has anybody seen my pants? Madge! Madge!
Hey, I don't know anything about it unless I have to put clothes on it. Man, you think this is the first opening night you guys have ever had?
Well, the lights are out in the dressing room.
Have you tried flipping the switch?
Huh? Oh!
Got a nice fresh pair of pants?
Has anybody seen Darla, and is she carrying a blunt object?
Aren't you going to warm up?
Oh, right. Good idea.
Here, take mine. Never mind the furthermore. The police self-defense.
Oh, sure. Give me that one.
Madge, have you seen my spear?
Just a second.
Never mind the furthermore. Wait a minute.
Will
Did somebody say Dina's
this?
Here?
I feel like a dancing bear.
If only I had a dancing bear, at least he could follow directions.
Yeah? Let's go look at the script.
Let's.
Did Dina come in here?
Dina, is she here?
I saw our car outside.
Just a second.
Has anyone seen Dina?
Darla, have you seen Madge?
Just a second. I'll get her.
Wait a minute. Did somebody say Dina's here?
Madge?
What? Dina's here?
Where's the police sergeant?
Well, we better find him.
Madge!
Let's split up.
Good idea. Look out! Watch it!
It's like a well-oiled machine.
Madge!
Just keep going, no matter what. You understand?
What if I hear gunshots?
Finish the scene and then check for wounds. Chuck, what's your problem?
I can't find my pants.
What are you holding there?
Oh, well, Dina gave these to me and... These look like my pants!
Like running a zoo. Chuck?
Yeah?
Go put your pants on.
Good idea.
Just keep going, gunshots and all.
Will you just think about your apart?
What if the killer shows up?
What makes you say that?
Dina! Not so loud! Oh, you want it to be a slow and silent death, huh? I don't think so.
Where have you been? I've been going crazy here.
Yeah, I figured when you pegged me for the killer.
Sorry about that.
Sorry, she says. Look, you want to catch the culprit? I'll show you how.
How?
I think she's gone.
There you are. How do I look?
Say, that's just great.
All I needed to hear.
Who was that?
I thought you knew. Hey, maybe it's Darla's friend, the one who wants to invest in the show.
Or maybe that other guy?
The one who wants to take the theater over from Habershaw? Who was that?
Oh, great. Now we got a buyer, a backer, and a Bobby.
Oh, that sounds like a play we'd do.
Did Mr. Latimer come in here?
Who's he?
He's the investor.
Was he dressed like an old English policeman?
Why would you ask that?
We have a spare one.
Your backer's already here?
I think so. Hang on.
I don't like this.
What?
What if Dina's already shot the investor?
Will you stop? Dina hasn't shot anyone.
Oh, yeah? Hey, guys, look what I got.
Dina, have you shot anyone?
Look, this will straighten everything out.
Are you nuts?
Now you think of asking that one.
Dina. She's in here.
Not again.
Will you people stop this?
I am really starting to not like this. I mean, I am not a strong person.
Lucy, this is no time to panic.
Oh, okay. Let me know when it is time.
Who are you?
Well, I'm not supposed to tell.
The buyer?
Or the backer?
Huh?
Oh. Bye-bye!
What did you do that for?
We have to find the cop.
Which one? The American Sergeant or the London Bobby?
That's it.
That's what?
The Bobby! That was Sergeant Hawk.
Let's go get him.
Good. Wait. You stay here in case he comes back.
But what if Dina gets here first?
You're on your own.
I'm not very good on my own.
Did they come through here?
Who?
Anybody.
They went this way and that way.
Let's go.
I knew it was you! It had to be you! I'm here all by myself, and it just had to be you!
It's me!
Yeah, I got that.
Listen, I know what you're thinking. Everyone else here is thinking it, but nobody knows what I know, see? But don't worry, I'll take care of that. I'll take care of everything!
But you're gonna take care of me first, right?
Just wait and see.
I'm just the assistant director!
Hey, enter and do our part. Then, on our next entrance, we find a dead body on the left side.
And there it is.
Now, look who I have here. Where'd he go?
Dina!
We've been looking all over for you.
Yeah, are you the killer or not?
She killed me. Huh? Be right back.
Wait!
I got him! Lucy? Lucy?
Still hanging on, but I don't have long.
I got him! Look! Here. I found... Oh. It's you again.
Yep. Again.
Get lost.
I can see my life passing in front of my eyes.
Now, where did I put that sergeant?
Just a few breaths left. Adieu.
Okay, now get in here. Where is he?
Where is who?
Mr. Latimer.
Did Dina come in here?
Did you guys see London Bobby back there?
No. Dad, I have an English muffin in the microwave.
She's not back here.
Who?
Where's the others? I'm not in shape for this. You should have taken those spinning classes with the rest of us.
Has anyone seen Sergeant Hawk?
Is he here?
Yeah, but in disguise.
Then how would we know if we've seen him?
Hey, I have an announcement to make.
What?
These pants don't fit. They're too tight.
Where is Sergeant Hawk?
Right here.
Sergeant, have you caught Dina?
Sort of. Let's just say we caught each other.
Dina?
I can see the great beyond unfolding. And that's not all I caught. Get in here.
Mr. Habershaw?
Oh, no. Look, Gracie, you know who this is.
Yes, I am Sergeant Hawk.
Wrong.
You are Marvin Trowbridge.
What?
I can see a white light at the end of the tunnel.
Shut up, Lucy.
That's right. I got tipped off when you said he first came by when you weren't here. It dawned on me. That seemed a little bit too coincidental. Like maybe you'd recognize him. Of course, then he got cocky.
I can explain everything.
I'll start. Trowbridge here is with the Carousel Community Theater Bunch. And I saw him play Sergeant Hawk in their production of Murder with a Side of Fries.
You're an actor?
Yes, but he paid me.
You paid him? But why?
To get me out of the theater.
Huh?
What? I better tell you. Mr. Habershaw is my dad.
Oh my God.
Your father?
I tried to get her to stop all this theater foolishness. So, I figured if I started that story about murder in the group, you guys would have to cancel the show. You know how gossip spreads in show business.
Where's here?
Nah.
Of course, then when I came here the other day and Dala saw me, well, I had to come up with something new. So, I invented that story about having a buyer to come over and take the theater.
Yeah, and blackmailed me into a date.
You had fun, didn't you?
Okay, so it's all cleared up now? So now, will you all relax? It's all over, okay?
Yes.
Caught the culprit single-handedly.
Wait, has anyone seen Mr. Latimer?
The backer?
Yeah, he was supposed to be here.
I think he left.
What?
Yeah, some guy in a dark suit said something about this being a madhouse and he was tired of being pushed in and out of doors.
Really? Now who would do such a thing?
I'm really sorry for all the problems I've caused.
I, still get paid though, right?
Shut up.
Anything else?
Oh, not much, only, don't you guys open in 5 minutes?
The show! Get into costumes! My spear!
My pants!
No!